called him the Reaper. He hid under a mask. His robe was splattered with the blood of his victims. The Reaper fought with regard for only one thing: victory. And he would sacrifice his own allies in order to attain it. His fiendish right arm made people wonder. Just how many had he absorbed? And here I was, partnered with the accursed Reaper. I'm out here on work.
Save my life. I beg of you.
The Reaper, satisfied with the catch, led us to our lodgings. Work with the Reaper begins here and ends here, like clockwork. At night, he goes off alone. One time, I went to the tavern. I was greeted by a man and a woman. Skeletum and Sponsara. Sponsara spoke first, leaning forward in anticipation.
Anything new?
They had already hired me. Uncover the identity of the Reaper. That was their request. Skeletum had a friend named Amicus. Amicus was an accomplished sorcerer. But he went on a journey with the Reaper, and never returned. The Reaper had sacrificed Amicus during battle. Amicus had a fiance. Her name was Sponsara. He had lost a friend, and she a soulmate. Perhaps their wounds will never heal. I had to bring the Reaper to justice. The next day, the Reaper had arrived at our meeting point ahead of me. Little does he know that I have been hired to unmask his identity.
Thank you. left undone. I can't die yet.
The sun set, and we returned to our base town. We parted ways as was normal, except I stayed on his tail. I had tried to follow him before, but he always seems to slip away. Tonight was no exception. One moment he was in clear view, the next moment, gone. I went to the bar to report to Skeletum and Sponsara. Sponsara was clearly disheartened the moment she realized that I had nothing new to tell them. Skeletum did his best to calm Sponsara as she became emotional. Every word, every gesture showed how much he cared. Sponsara had too many drinks and passed out on the counter. Skeletum, who normally spoke little, suddenly opened up. He spoke with a warm kindness. He told me that he was falling in love with his friend's fiance. And that Sponsara had shown a mutual fondness. In fact, they had made the promise that they would live together. Once they exacted revenge. The next day came. The Reaper stood waiting at our usual spot. The monsters we would face on this day were fiercer than ever before. I knew that today I might be the sacrifice. Just as Amicus was long ago.
My work is left undone. I can't die yet.
The Reaper had been hit. His mask was cracked, revealing part of his face. The broken mask revealed a sight of the very man who had asked me to do this.
Let me explain.
Skeleton spoke. Matter-of-factly. He admitted he was the Reaper. He had led a life of bloodshed and murder. But that everything changed the moment he absorbed a certain man. Amicus. But Amicus was unique. His passion outlived his own life. This passion flowed through the Reaper's right arm and took root in his mind. It was overpowering. Amicus is love. For Sponsara. He concealed the fact he was the Reaper, approaching Sponsara under his real name, Skeleton. He had kept up his charade since. How devastated would Sponsara be if she ever knew the truth? The notorious Reaper was torn. With her fiancé murdered, Skeleton had become her emotional rock. Whatever affection she showed toward Skeleton caused him guilt. The guilt was weighing on him. If he, the Reaper, were to die, then Sponsara's wish for revenge would be fulfilled. But at the same time, she would lose someone dear.
They call me the Reaper, and although it may be short-lived, I have accepted you as a friend. Did you ever wonder why? Should I live, or should I die? I need somebody to decide for me.
The Reaper raised his accursed arm and descended upon me.
In the balance, and you shall decide my fate. I have deceived Sponsor for so very long. But I'd fallen in love with Sponsor. Would it pain her to know the truth? I can no longer. Kill me.
That was what he really wanted. He wanted an easy way out. Liberation from guilt. I told him how I felt. He'd chosen to live as the Reaper. Now, he must reap what he had sown. Skeletum settled onto the ground, moaning with woe. I have not seen the Reaper since. But after some time, I received a letter from Skeletum. But it was tinged with grief. The sacred chalice has the power to grant a wish. He would use it to erase Sponsara's memories of and affection for Skeletum. Finally, the Reaper could die. And Sponsara would have her revenge. It was a grievous conclusion. Perhaps it was a self-inflicted punishment. The Reaper would return to battle in search of the sacred chalice to avenge Sponsara without harming her. A final gesture to the one he loved.